Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight I'm going to reply to a question which was about Spring Boot and MongoDB. So if you have no interest in MongoDB, Mongo Query or the Mongo template in Spring Boot, then this video is not for you. If you like, if you have any interest in that, of course this video is exactly for you. And we're coding in Java. So the question was, could you please show me an example of a query that was a little bit more complex and where we are using objects deeper down in the hierarchy than in the root? That was a question. Yes, of course. So I took my old and sour Spring Boot MongoDB query project that I had on GitHub. First of all, I've upgraded the Gradle version to 6.4.1. So if you are one of those who have cloned my project, just pull it and then don't be afraid when you get a new Gradle version there. I have also changed something in the application of properties file. I've added this line right here. So the JSON that we get returned is pretty printed. So that's actually what it means, pretty print. It indents each field so it looks nice in the console. The first thing I did was also to look at the Docker, the Docker script that we have right here, and then I converted that into a Docker Compose file instead because it's much more elegant. You can just write Docker Compose up and down and build stuff like that. It's much easier. So there's a Docker Compose file now. Then I've created a curl captain name that we're going to use in just a minute. Let us go look at the Java code itself that we have right here. So the situation is that early on we have a space station and we have a spaceship. Tonight we're only going to play around with the spaceship. Inside the spaceship, I've added a new field right here, which is captain. So that is how I'm creating a deeper object structure. I'm also creating a captain right now. And the captain is actually quite simple. A captain just has a name and then it has a level of from 0 to 5 of how good a driver or flyer this captain is, right? I'm using Lombok as usual, so I am using the data, the NoAuth constructor and the AllAuth constructor right there. In this project, we had some services which could return data. So we already had this all the sources service, which actually queried out all the spaceships which has the type equal to saucer. That was pretty simple, and we also sorted them by the engine type. So that was the project as it was. Then I added to this, and you can see here it's annotated with service, so it's a Spring service and has the Mongo template right there. And you can actually see I've actually created a constructor right there, but there's no reason for doing that because we can just add NoArch, all required Arch constructor in the top right here. Then it's a bit nicer. Then Spring Lombok will actually create the constructor for us. And then Spring will inject the Mongo template through constructor injection. But then I created this method right here, which is find for captain. That means that now we are trying to find something where we have the captain set to some name. And that means that I'm creating a new query just like before. And then I'm adding a criteria where. And here comes the magic here. And this is what the question was all about. How do I target something deeper down the object hierarchy? Also, how do I target a sub document? And this is exactly how I do it. You just mention the name captain and then dots the field name inside the captain. So that means because I have named this captain right here, then I start with captain. And then inside the captain, then the field is called name. And that means that then I can just add a criteria that says where this field is and then name like that, and then again I can sort on the Indians if that's what I want to, and I can also limit by 4, so then I only maximum can get 4 spaceships returned. And then I call Mongo template dot find and then the query, and then again the spaceship that is the name, that is the document, that is the document that we have created down in the Mongo database. So if you're not familiar with NoSQL databases, this is kind of the same as a table in a SQL database, but not exactly anyway. But it's a long story, but in NoSQL databases, we have documents instead. That means that we have, actually, it's almost the same as the output in the console when we are serializing to JSON. It's almost the same. It's something called JSON instead that, it resembles a lot to JSON, but there are small minor differences. But that was what I created. Then I created a REST controller, and it actually just, you can see right here, REST controller, REST request mapping, we didn't have that already, so spaceship and required ask constructor. That means that then I can inject the spaceship service automatically, but with the constructor, the Slumbok who creates that again. Then I have a mapping right here, and I'm using a request parameter to my endpoint. That means that the request parameter called captain name will then be taken, and then we will use that as argument to the spaceship service where we find for captain. We find all the spaceship that has that captain's first name. Where there's a captain with that name. So that is what we are doing right here. I hope it makes sense, because I've already started up the Docker I could have pressed the green button here, but I actually went to a console, and yeah, and then I ran Docker Compose up, and you can see that my Mongo database is running as expected right there, and because I'm running on the default port 27017, then I don't have to configure any data connection in my application to properties. It would actually just look for the localhost and 27017, so that is quite good. And the application is already up and running. You can see here it's up and running right there. Then I have my curl script right here, and here you can see localhost 8080, and then I go to the endpoint spaceship with a slash in end, and then question mark and captain name equals Mike. But why do all these captains come from? Have we created some captains already? Yes, because when we started up the application, then I had this init data. This is a component right here. And I had the post construct on top of a method. That means that after this component has been created, then this code will actually be run. This method here will actually be run. And in this method, we have a spaceship repository. And we have a constructor. Why didn't I use Lombok? Let us just add required ask constructor also there. And okay, in this method here that will be called just after creating one instance of the class init data, then we will call this data right here. And first of all, we delete all the spaceships. So if already some spaceships created or modified, they will just be flushed out with them, out in the toilet with them. Or maybe there's not room enough in the toilet, so maybe in the big recycling bin instead. And here we have the save all. So that means that here we are creating a lot of new spaceships from a list. So we are feeding the repository save all method with a list of spaceships. Inside my spaceship, I've added a new captain. That's a new thing. I forgot to tell you about this also. I've also coded this. I add new captain, and I gave three of the spaceships the captain Mike, and of course the flying skill is 5. And yes, 5 is maximum in this scenario right here. It is not from 0 to 100. It is from 0 to 5, or maybe from 1 to 5. And then I have Jens, and then I have Torben, and then I have Jan, and then I have Susan, and then I have Helen, and I've given them some different values. So that is why then we have some data to query on. Let us try Susan and Jan afterwards. But first of all, let us try Mike. Let us see what I get returned. I should get 3 spaceships, just as a spoiler. It's always nice to know what you would expect, right? So here, we have 3 spaceships. Whoa. I impressed myself again and again. We have the Falcon, and here we have the captain. Name equals Mike, level 5, and the same with the flying saucer. And I'm also on a captain on the fancy flyer. That is pretty cool. Okay. That is pretty cool. Let us try with maybe it was just luck, so let us try with Jan instead. And these names are just made up names. It's not enough. It's nothing from real life. Just so if you're watching this and your name is Jan, do not be offended. But you shouldn't, because your level is actually 5, so there's no problem with that. Here we have type Eagle, and Jan is the captain right here. Let's try with Susan also. Susan. Oh, that was the name of a country. Let us just try Susan instead. Run. And yes, Susan, she has the Eagle plane, and she has a level of 2. Yeah. Then we have Helen. Let us try Helen. And here we got Helen, and she has a level of 5, and she's flying the spaceship named Tweety Bird, and with this ID right here. If this was not advanced enough, then try to write me in the comments again and ask what you want to. I think MongoDB and the Mongo template and the queries regarding NoSQL databases, it is an exciting area, and we could make a lot of cool things that is much more advanced than this example here, of course. So just write me, and then I will I'll create some more videos about Mongo databases and how to query them. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a great evening. I hope to see you again soon. Bye bye.